was set to next week for some reason, so
okay.
Hopefully that's the reason people were
actually, I need to do that on my game.
My other game, pretty much every holiday seems to be, this summer seems to be falling on Mondays, of course, so. So we keep getting canceled. We've got 4th of July coming up in way too close, and my other game is going to probably be canceled on that day too, so. Ah, well. All right, I'm going to take a little quick break, and I'll be back before 9. So.
Okay. All right, can everyone still hear me? Ah, crap, do I have to restart Discord again?
I can hear you.
Okay, good. It decided to stop working earlier. Oh, Nathan, where did you find these character sheets?
Okay, who's on?
Rolling.
Looks like it's just the guys.
The dudes.
You okay. Appear to have been away when I asked, where did you find
the sheets? Oh, bloody hell.
For this, the I run of that 5th edition, they might be interested.
Okay. I can't hear anybody.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
All right, let's switch over to D20. Roll 20.
I don't wanna.
How's that? Hello?
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 Well, I can hear the two of you.
Okay.
Can you hear us now?
That's all that really matters. We don't need Nathan.
How's it going?
Can you hear us?
Yeah, we can hear you. Can you hear us?
Oh, that's interesting.
What?
My computer muted.
That would do it.
That's super. Yeah, that would do it. But I think we're fine.
Okay.
This works cool. Relatively well.
I was trying to ask where you found the character sheets that we're using.
The character sheets that we're using? Those were the default D20 or fifth edition.
They're just defaulting roll 20?
Oh, yeah.
That works.
Okay, so where were we last time that we were in the game?
Well, we had celebrated a little bit, and we just got out of the Underdark, found the gnome. Huzzah. He did his business, talked to the council people. We found a boat, made a little bargain, played a little tune, got ourselves a free ride, but we have to keep doing that, otherwise we're screwed.
Okay.
And I think we just shipped off on a boat.
I was chosen by some goo to lead the whatchamacallit.
Also, Charlie was too drunk to help fight.
Yep, yes. She got wasted.
She and made some astute comments, but that's neither here nor there.
So yeah, okay. We're on the Daisy Cutter with John Rare.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And Trella and Trella's Minotaur man. What's his name? Gurish.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The day is bright blue and filled with promise as you leave the port and enter the great Eye Lake. You are able to make really good time cutting along the shore of the lake, moving in a northwestern direction. After a couple of days of travel, you reach a canal that goes out, and you reach the, a short time later, you reach the, you're hauled along by a cart system and mules that take you downriver to the locks that exist at the town of Cliff Watch.
Okay.
you're slowly lowered down into the sea, and it spreads out before you, and you continue your journey. Hey, do you guys want to stop at Cliff Watch, do anything there, pick anything up?
I can't think of anything.
I don't know. What do we know, if there would be anything interesting at Cliff Watch?
It's a small city, so there, it's possible, but the ship will dock and probably take on some provisions from there, just, you know, restock. So you have the opportunity to leave the ship if you want to before it descends to the sea.
I think I'm okay.
Do we want to buy like a million harpoons?
Doesn't the ship have cannons?
The ship does have cannons.
Oh, okay, then we're good.
John Rare talked about them like they were the best thing since sliced bread.
Ooh. Roland would like to go to city for a quick pick up.
Okay.
He is looking for a bookstore.
After a short period of time, you're able to find a bookstore in Cliff Watch.
Okay.
Anything in particular that you're looking for?
I am. I'm looking for a book on sea creatures.
Sea creatures. Okay. You're able to find a book on sea creatures.
Okay. I'll ask the man. Excuse me, sir. I wish to purchase this book on sea creatures. How much does that run me?
20 gold pieces, please.
I consider that a fair deal, and I hand him 20 gold pieces.
Okay.
And I will begin thumbing through it as I return back to the boat.
Okay.
That is all.
Okay. Anybody else want to make any stops while you're passing through Cliff Watch's locks?
I probably will think of something right after we leave.
The ship is slowly lowered through a series of locks created by the dwarves with dwarven engineering. It is an impressive thing to see as these giant gates open and close and you move from and are lowered down by hydraulic pressure. It's eventually you reach the ocean below, and you set sail out of Cliff Watch, leaving it behind with its magnificent locks, on your way to Barsum.
Very well.
Okay. So it's a few days later when you suddenly feel through the deck plating of the deck, a grinding. And great. You hear the sound of discontent in the ship. Generally people are upset and trying to figure out what's going on.
I'm gonna try to find the captain.
John Rare?
Yeah.
You find him, and he says, "I don't know what this is. It's like something is chewing on the boat."
Well, that's comforting to hear.
Didn't you just get a book about sea creatures?
I run to the side of the boat and look over.
Okay. Roll an investigate roll on that.
Not perception?
Perception or investigate, either one, depending on what you're doing. Okay. Oh my. Bale, you can see down into the water that there is a extremely large shark that's chewing on the side of the boat.
Oh, wonderful.
You all see this.
A giant shark eating the boat.
Yep.
How killable does it look?
It looks like it's definitely killable, but and it's going to take a while.
Hey, Roland.
What?
Chuck one of your animals from your bag out there, and maybe we can divert it for a minute. Get it away from the boat so they can fire the cannons at it.
I thought we were going to have, like, a bet to see who would win. I was like, okay. I bet
we could do that, too.
All right. I'm going to toss 2 fluff balls out into the air.
Okay.
As far as you can.
Oh, wrong one. There we go. Hey, a bear!
And a rat.
All right. Hopefully the bear lands, like, right on the shark. That would be ideal.
Yep. Bear versus shark.
All right. I think a bear can swim, right?
A bear can swim, yes.
I assume so. Not as fast as a shark. But
maybe you could control that bear to swim away from the boat.
I think we can just tell it to attack it for a couple seconds so we can get...
Well, the farther it swims away, the better, I think, shot we'll have with the cannons, don't you think?
I don't think it's going to get very far if you're racing a shark.
Yeah.
Probably get, like, 5 feet away.
Okay. The shark quickly snaps up the rat and turns itself towards the bear.
Rawr.
Yes, definitely rawr.
I yell at John Rare and tell him to start shooting the cannons at the distracted shark.
It's not far enough out.
I told you, Roland, you should have had the bear swim away.
Well, we should start doing something, too, while it's distracted with the bear.
Are there any casks of powder?
There are casks of powder.
Okay, I run to get a cask of powder.
Okay.
Is that initiative?
No, that is an attack on the bear.
Oh, okay. That hits, actually.
It hits. Yes. Okay. So now you get an idea of what you're dealing with.
Oh, yeah.
The bear is able to continue swimming away, but looks like a good chunk of it was taken out by bite from the shark.
Oh yeah.
The ship is moving outwards. The hope is, of course, that the cannon might take it out. What are you doing with the powder?
Hanging on to it for right now.
Okay. We're gonna need a bigger boat.
I was gonna say, smile, you son of a bitch.
Already a firebolt to shoot at that cask.
Okay.
Please wait till I put it in the water. The shark has it in its mouth.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, I'm just staring at the cask with a fireball in my hand going, let's go. Throw it.
We got to make it more appetizing, I think.
The third.
Okay. I guess the brown bear is just going to do a dash. Win as far as you can away.
Okay.
I don't know what a bear's swimming speed is.
Yeah, I don't know if it really has a swimming speed. It should have a swimming speed, but
it's regulation speed is 40.
Does it matter?
So you want to do
it doesn't really matter because it's fighting a shark. That's very true. And it's not just a normal shark. It's a giant shark.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Do you want to... Is he going to... He's sprinting away.
Yep, just dashing. So double water speed. Regular speed is 40 feet, so... Maybe he just dashes and goes 40 feet. I don't know.
Okay. Well, that's not enough because...
Because it's a shark.
It's a shark, yes. Yeah. Yeah. And the bear is snapped in half. The shark looks very disappointed when it turns into a ball of fluff and floats to the surface.
Yeah. I laugh at it.
Disappointment is part of life, shark.
I yell at John Rear, is he far enough away to fire yet?
Aye.
Okay. Okay, we'll see if they hit.
Gunner is able to hit.
What's the damage on a cannon? Hit it. Oh, yes.
A good section of the giant shark is blown away, but it seems to still be, it starts to swim back towards the ship.
Goodness. Bayo, you ready?
I was going to say, Tanner, is there any way to throw another, like, of your ball of tricks and we tie this cast to its back and then throw it overboard?
If it was big enough. Depends what
well, are we gonna take a gamble?
Sure. Throw my last one for the day. That's a goat. How big's the cast?
Perfect.
Four. A goat! That'll work.
Okay, you were able
whatever.
To grab
I'm gonna
the,
lash this cask to this goat's back.
If you some rope and do that. Yeah, do a survival roll on that.
See how good you can.
Would that be survival? Would that be survival?
The goat runs off in terror.
Oh shit!
I commanded to come back.
And you're not proving to be the hero that we need. And in this case, well deserved. I don't know. I seem like a smart goat to me.
That's amazing.
Okay.
Can't you like command the goat to let Bayo strap explosives to it?
Yeah, I'll command it to come over and then just wrestle it to the ground.
Can't you command it to?
I think commanding it to be like absolutely still would just kind of
You get a fate point for that one because that made me laugh more than it should have.
Who does?
You do, Dom.
Awesome.
That's amazing.
Die explosives. Oh my god.
Should I roll to wrestle it to the ground then?
You don't have to roll to wrestle it to the ground. It does what you want it to, but it was a little freaked out by its survival check.
Oh my goodness!
Is I'm seven enough for mine. To just
no,
tie
a... no, tie a knot? I would. Yeah, I think it's fine. Yeah.
What? What? How is this possible? Quick, tell Yolanda to roll a survival roll. I'm sure it's better than any
of
you
don't want her to, because she will fail.
Apparently.
Our best roll so far has been a 7.
And that's a natural fail anyway.
Landa steps up.
Still better than mine. It's not a natural fail. That's amazing. A 1-1-1 and a 2.
While you're doing that, the shark has swum back over and is chewing on the boat again.
Gosh dang it. He's gonna tear our boat up. I say just drop it over the edge and then throw the goat over and see what happens. We need to get it off the boat.
Okay. You do.
Okay. In the meantime, he gets another attack on the boat. Okay. There is, you're pretty sure that he's chewed through the bottom of the boat, so it's now starting, the ship is now starting to flood.
Guys, we're really good at this.
Alright, is the cask in the water? Close to
yeah,
the
you pushed it over. The cask is in the water. The goat is now dead, basically, because the shark immediately swims over to the prey that is mewling in the water. And he now has the cask in his mouth.
I firebolt that so quick. Does a 26 hit?
That will hit. And that blows, basically, the shark up. I'm not going to even bother rolling for that because you guys handled that very well.
Goodness.
It's a la Jaws. You handled it fantastically.
It was ridiculous.
Unfortunately, the ship is now sinking.
I don't know what to do about that. I got nothing. No spells. No tools. Captain, what do you want us to do? Hey, Yolanda's here. Yolanda, tell us what to do. I killed a shark for you. Now fix the boat.
Oh, she's probably on, let me check to see if she's on Discord. Yeah, looks like she is. no, she isn't. Just typed to her that we're using...
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, just...
Okay.
You should read it.
I am good at computers. That's what I do for a living. Let's just put it this way. I'm better than, like, 70-year-old attorneys at computers, so...
I can see that.
Is this an accomplishment?
It keeps me in work.
I've worked with 70-year-old attorneys. It's really bad.
I've worked with 70-year-old oil men. That's really bad. They not only can't use computers, they are offended at the idea of having to do so.
Mudlogs. You probably have been up here. I've done some work with mudlogs. They're fun.
Yeah. Were you a mudlogger?
No. We had a oil and gas case that we had to basically go through them. They're really quite cool with the various.
Yeah, they are.
But yeah.
Every time I sent in my end of shift report, I started wanting to play Dwarf Fortress.
Exactly.
And then I remembered that, no, I don't actually hate myself that much yet. Yolanda!
Charlie. Well, in the meantime, I still go to the captain and ask him what we need to do.
He's like, well, water's flooding in the bay. We got to start bailing it out.
The water?
Water, we're bailing it out.
Okay.
So,
I'll grab some buckets.
Okay, so a bucket chain forms and you're able to start moving water out. They have some patches that they're trying to apply to where the shark started to chew through the hull.
Well, don't ask us for help putting up the patches after what happened with the goat to the rope.
You're not. And so they're able to start sealing up the hull breach. It's not pretty, but they bring in some patch. They bring in some pitch. You can do a strength check to try to help out with that.
With the patches?
Yeah.
I don't know if I want.
Nice. You are holding up like three boards in one in each hand and one with your mighty girth. as Elvin, as yeah, never mind.
Elvin girth.
Yes. Yep. And so they're able to start sealing up the hull breach. It's not pretty, but they bring in some patch. They bring in some pitch and start sealing it up. They say that they're probably going to have to add back to Cliff Watch.
Okay.
If we have to, I guess.
We could get some proper tieable ropes while we're there.
You turn around, the ship turns around and you're able to sail back to Cliff Watch. You dock in the lower harbor. And it's going to be probably at least a week before you can be back on the ship, back on the sea.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to save my book for that whole time.
Okay.
Unless our group decides to do something. I don't know if we want to do something.
Okay. Anything you want to do in Cliff Watch? You're pretty darn far away from it. It's about 2 or 3 days out of Barsum, and Barsum is probably a week's ship right away. So you're several hundred miles away.
That's a good ways away, yeah.
Basically, Cliff Watch is made up of several levels. The locks cut through the center of the city and sort of go underneath the
underneath the cliffs and then rise back up into the canal that leads out into the Great Eye Lake. It's one of the more prosperous trading cities, just simply because it recently opened up, and it basically allows trade to Labyrinthium and the other towns along the Great Eye Lake, and also gives access to the Blue Line River that separates the east from the west on the continent of Novaris. So basically, it opening up has opened up the entire continent.
So it's like a water crossroads?
Yeah, pretty much a water crossroads.
Cool. A lot of business to be had.
It's going to be about a week for them to finish up fixing the ship, because there was a significant amount of damage. You were able to patch it up, but it's not going to hold for long term. Luckily, you're only about a day's journey out from Cliff Watch.
I'd say that we do a repair montage while the audience checks in on Jika.
Okay. What is Jika up to? Jika is rocking back and forth in the fetal position in the corner of one of the rooms. There are small fairies flying around with matches, and
what? Jika, kick their ass. You were trained.
Truly, a mightier warrior the Goblin race has never produced.
You guys wait.
My I've Goblin General.
My Goblin General right there.
Okay, so you guys are just going to wait around, or are you going to try to figure out, poke around the city?
We can try to find a job over here. Maybe spread the name of us, the rebellion, and or warning of what we fought. There's a lot we could do.
Okay. Things are pretty calm in the city right now, actually. There were some problems earlier on with kobolds stealing equipment, but now that and some issues with an ancient tomb, but they pretty well have been resolved by some of the local adventurers. And in general, things are pretty good there. You do hear about a problem with some hounds in the outer in a wood camp nearby.
Yeah, I forgot about them.
They've been terrorizing the wood camp,
so they're not after us for now.
Yeah, but that's the last thing we want to do is provoke more fey hounds after us. We already got to deal with that.
Do they have any cold iron ammunition here?
You could definitely ask at the local alchemist.
I will do so.
When do we have to be at that one meeting? Weren't we supposed to be at like some tribunal thing?
We're supposed to go to the meeting whenever we get to Barsum.
Yeah, we have a fortnight once we get to Barsum or something.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh yes.
Well, I mean, we could try to talk to someone and see if they want the problem gone. Maybe we can make something out of it.
Yeah.
So you're going to head out to the lumber camp?
Stop at the alchemist along the way?
Okay. Stop at a local alchemist, and you ask about
cold iron ammunition. He does know the secret of coating things with cold iron. And he says that it's going to be about 20 gold pieces for a cold iron arrow.
For a cold iron arrow?
Yeah, it's a specific type of...
Yeah, I'll make good with force damage. Thanks. Goodbye.
Okay. That's expensive.
Could make the arrow out of pure gold. You could make an entire batch of arrows out of pure gold.
For 20 gold.
Yes.
But they'd be useless.
Hey, she speaks.
So would one cold iron arrow. This isn't Smaug we're going up against.
Could he cold iron a sword for me? How much would that be?
Willing to do it for 100 gold pieces. To cold steel a weapon. Cold iron.
Yeah, I don't need that shit.
Yeah. Okay.
Maybe we should go find somebody. Is there like a wood camp warden or business that owns it in town?
You're able to, after a little bit of questioning, you find out that there is a foreman in town. He is a Minotian, and he says, when he sees you, he says, "What can I do for you?" Are you looking to help us with our issue with the hounds?
She who speaks well, talk.
Hello. Yes, we've heard about your problem with some hounds, and we've dealt with that kind of issue before, and are willing to lend our assistance.
Well, it's really only one hound, but he's big.
How big?
Very big.
As big as a house.
No, not as big as a house.
Small
maybe
cabin.
A hut.
A hut. I don't know. Still pretty big.
Go ahead.
Does it have any noticeable traits to it, like frost breath?
Well, yes, it does. It's a creature of cold.
Oh, well, that's fine. We have a lot of fire.
Yeah, but... we'll talk about it later.
When you were... cutting the forest down, did you notice any other disturbances?
No, when we were cutting, one day we just... came upon it just was in one spot, and when it saw us, it started to attack. We got out of there as soon as we could.
Okay.
Well, let's kill it.
What would be the reward for us removing this crazed animal in your wood camp?
Well, can provide you with, wood, yes, if you seek wood, we can definitely give you that. We have some very nice timber, actually. Build
our furniture out of it.
Provide, we can provide, let's see here, 60 gold pieces each.
How much are you losing a day by not being able to cut?
Not a whole lot. Probably 20 gold pieces a day.
Well,
how many men have died?
5.
Ugh. Well, how about we just take care of it, and you can maybe just, you know, spread the word of how
everybody
amazing.
Everybody is kind of...
Because we're amazing, and we need more people to know how amazing we are.
And we'll take the 60 gold pieces and timbers for our ship.
Yeah, sure.
I guess that too.
Sound like a deal?
Sounds like a deal. We can definitely provide you with timbers for your ships. Some of the finest.
Could you maybe do that at down payment for assistance? I mean, they're kind of working on the ship as we speak.
Yes, we can provide that for you.
Okay. Point us in the right direction. And
let's go back and tell the captain first that we have procured lumber for the repair.
True.
Okay. Excellent. You certainly have earned your keep.
Well, we try.
Thank you for that.
Alright.
Kill a duck.
Yeah, we'll be back. We're gonna go kill something. Don't leave without us. We'll be back.
I'm not planning on leaving.
Okay. Did we get directions from?
Yeah, you received directions. It's only a short ways away from Cliff Watch.
Oh,
yep.
You are cutting off a lot.
Should we go back to that one thing?
Discord. Yeah, I guess we could.
No, I think we're good, but let's head back.
My problem is wrong with my headset.
Discard.
No, that's interesting. Okay, I guess back to Discord then.
Cool.
Yeah, I couldn't hear Orion at all.
Okay. Can everybody hear each other?
Hi.
All right, can everybody?
Good.
Yeah.
Where's Charlie?
Just went. Lost.
All right. Oh, he beat me to it. Well, mine goes directly into the thing, but both work. All right, can we talk about this as we make our way yonder? I'm guessing northward.
Sure.
So do we really want to kill another Fey Hound and piss off the Hay even that much more?
No, we really don't. But when has that stopped us?
It's true. I mean,
we're already having to go to a tribunal, so. And I'm assuming we're going to have to fight something in order to prove our innocence or something.
Maybe.
I don't think that our innocence is going to be what we're proving when we've, you know, start killing things at the Fey Court.
It was all because we killed that one witch. If I recall correctly.
Well, right now, this hound has nothing to do with us. And us getting in the middle of it would kind of add to our tribunal discussion.
Maybe we could end it peacefully.
Yeah.
With the hound?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of wondering, like, should we figure out what it's there for? Is it, like, guarding something?
Yeah, if it's guarding something,
it's
maybe we
can... It's a logging camp.
Well, maybe it doesn't like that the trees are being cut down.
Exactly.
Well, then what are we going to do?
Plant some trees.
So that they can get cut down again.
Convince them to be more environmentally friendly.
Let's just go check this dog out first and see what's going on. Does anybody speak? Does anybody speak Fey?
Don't everyone look at me at once.
What we're all doing.
Yep.
You did this to yourself.
Elvish, Draconic, Dwarvish, and Undercommon, and Thieves Can't. So, no.
Which is like twice as many languages as the rest of us.
Oh, yeah, I know.
I speak Elvish and Common. And Draconic. Jagoob.
Well, I got one from my class. One from my class, two from my background, and one from my subclass. Subrace. Yeah. It's weird. But it's great. I love it. It's only come in handy like once.
Though if you spoke Gnomish, it would have been...
I know! Except for my... It's so useful. It's whatever.
Learn Gnomish.
Oh, I'm going to. I'm going to pick up the, like, language feed or whatever that's called. Just because. I don't know.
Well, maybe if we can't speak Fey, we can try to communicate some other way with it.
Do we know if the Fey dogs speak at all?
Yes, they speak Cold Blast.
I hate that language.
Well, let's see, like, that language. Would it be like a nature or an arcana roll or something to see if any of us do know if it's possible to communicate with Fey creatures?
Yeah, we'll go with an arcana or nature roll, whichever one you want to take a chance at.
They're both terrible.
So we can learn the language of the Fey Enforcer Beasts, but we can't strap a bomb to a goat.
No. Not at all.
Hey. That was under a pressurized situation. That was high stakes. It was a shark.
We almost died.
You're pretty sure that, Roland, Alanda, and Orion are pretty sure that they can understand Fey, but they don't necessarily speak.
But they probably don't understand Common.
They don't understand Common, no.
No. Of course not. That would be silly.
Are we walking that way right now? Are we heading that direction? Do I notice any like seedlings along the edge of the trail? Small trees.
Yeah, you notice some small trees.
Can I dig one up?
Sure.
That's okay. Right. Make things worse.
Have Bayo's decision ever stayed us wrong?
Bayo saved our butts last time, so I'm gonna give him a couple more shots.
You guys have to remember I am now Bayo the Goo Chosen, so
yeah.
Nothing is a bad idea. Yolanda said so herself.
True. Then if I say it, it's true.
Yeah, she does magic.
How science works.
How many bottles of wine were you in when you were watching us?
You say bottle like you expect me to have an alcohol tolerance. It's really hard.
Sips?
About half a glass when I started.
Oh, jeez. That's funny. Okay. So you head through the woods, gathering up saplings, apparently. And
I am. How many saplings do I have?
You're able to find 4 or 5 small plants.
Okay. I'll help him. Carry some.
I facepalm. Okay.
You this is gonna work.
Maybe if I facepalm you reach enough, I'll concuss myself to the point where the things that Bayo does make sense.
It could only help. You're able to reach the edge of the lumber camp, and you can see in the distance a huge dog creature. Its body is covered in runes, glowing blue.
This might be a different situation here.
Is it not one of the fey hounds that we keep murdering?
It looks like a fey hound, but it's bigger and it has these runes all over it.
Oh, great.
Maybe we should go get Trella. We do have a glyph gnome with us.
Did the runes look like the ones that we have encountered on the...
Roll an intelligence check on that one.
Got this. Oh, that's a save. What the? Stop. Ignore that. Yeah, there we go.
Roland, they don't appear to you to be similar to the runes that you've seen before. These appear to be something else altogether. They almost are like... They're almost like decorations.
Yeah. That's great.
Are they anything that magic users can read?
Nothing that you recognize.
They're probably fey runes.
How many, looking around the camp, how many trees have been cut down and how much damage has been done to the forest?
It looks like they're pretty selective about what they're cutting down. They're cutting down only the bigger trees. They seem to be leaving a lot of shrubs and smaller trees alone. The tree that the hound is next to has been tipped over, and its roots are splayed all around.
Is it a big tree?
Oh, it's huge.
Does that look like a significant tree in any way?
It's definitely one of the older trees in the forest.
Maybe it's the older ones are the more powerful ones, or, you know.
The wisest. Well, does the wolf see us at this point?
It does see you. And it's holding its ground.
So how can we approach it?
I feel like we have no idea about this situation. I think this is something we have no idea about.
And probably shouldn't get involved with.
I mean, I'm probably curious.
Probably, but... is a very strong word.
I promised that Minotian that we're the most awesome people ever. I can't turn my back on that.
That was the promise.
Well, that just means that if we can't solve it, nobody can, and thus they should start chopping down trees somewhere else. And never, ever come here to check on our story.
I feel like there's a deeper meaning we need to know first.
Yeah, I'm willing to try to, like, you know, peacefully, or attempt, you know, try to sort something out.
What if we help the wolf, and then the fae, like, lets us off easy, because we helped it?
Well, I'm sure a camp full of loggers are a relatively low CR encounter.
You know what, we own a ton of land with a ton of trees. We can just tell them they can, like, log on our land if they really want some trees. I know it's forever away, but...
Yeah, that's kind of, probably going to be a bit of a stumbling block in the negotiations.
I think we try to work through this situation here. I think we can do it.
Talk through it, or...
Well, I don't, we'll see what happens here.
Okay, how do we...
You guys got my back?
I definitely don't have your front, so...
Okay.
Yeah, it's okay if you do. No one is gonna judge.
I definitely don't have his front.
I'm gonna move forward a little bit.
Okay.
Should we put our weapons down first?
Plant what? No, I've no weapons at all and no sign of aggression, and plant one of the saplings.
Okay. As you approach,
you die.
Instantly dead.
Just like the goat.
Chomp.
Don't get Bayo out of a bag.
I'm glad you guys didn't tie a cask of gunpowder to my back.
Oh, the ideas we have now. Gosh. You would have been fine, right?
He shifts, and all of a sudden one of the glyphs on, or the runes on his back shifts out and sort of lifts up and surrounds him, and a wall of ice surrounds the himself in that tree.
Excuse me. Well,
did he see me plant the sapling?
He did see you plant the sapling.
Is he, like, in a bubble, or just, you know, got a wall around him?
It's a wall around him.
Can I mage hand, like, I don't know, do we have any white cloth?
No. I don't think he would know what that meant anyway.
Yeah, but whoever's controlling him might, right? They always have, like, some sort of, they're not just... They're always sent for a mission, or they have a purpose, so that means they're controlled.
I think he's just protecting the tree, like that tree.
Well, he's being told to protect the tree. By whom is the question? And if we could communicate with them...
Yeah. How about... I'll go forward a bit and be like, we wish to speak with the keepers of this forest.
Nice. Good language.
Or we request an audience.
tribunal.
No, that's completely different. That's not what
we want. Don't remind them.
An audience and definitely not a tribunal, please.
Oh, okay. Not
a tribunal for us, at least.
I plant another tree.
We seek to resolve matters between you and the people nearby peacefully.
I'll bend a knee.
And more trees.
You have all the trees.
You said you took some too.
I was hoping you carry them.
Oh. Okay. I move and I plant another tree.
Oh gosh.
No, no.
The silence from the DM is not making me happy.
Hello!
Appearing behind, next to you, Yolanda, is a creature that looks to be sort of skeletal and glows bluish.
Same blue as the wolf?
Yeah.
Okay.
You wish an audience, she says.
Yes, we do. We want to resolve whatever issue there is between yourselves and the people nearby peacefully so that no one else has to die.
And no more damage is done.
Die. There's no escaping the end.
Die sooner than they're meant to.
We want them to die old in their beds.
So then nobody else has to be killed.
And no more damage is done.
No more damage is done. All things fall. All things end. All things fall to pieces. All things rend.
Well, as optimistic as that viewpoint is, we were hoping that maybe we could not have that happen anytime soon between your people and those nearby.
Answer this riddle, then.
Yay. Riddles.
Okay.
Pen and paper. Here we go. At one end is death. The other, the guiding hand. Use me wisely, or it shall be your end.
Sorry, say that again.
At one end death, the other the guiding hand. Use me wisely, or it shall be your end.
Sword.
Close.
Or some other similar weapon.
It is but a piece of the riddle.
Piece of the what?
Piece of the riddle.
Not as precious as the highest gold. And but friend to Fae, times of old. Tool of many, tool of craft, metal friend, all shall last.
Metal friend, what? I'm typing this down.
It It shall last.
Is there a type of metal that the Fae
I mean, there's no metal.
Yeah. Oh.
All metal decays over time.
Alanda, you're pretty sure that they might be referring to copper.
Huh. I thought it might have been mithril. Is it copper?
A copper sword?
So be it.
Killed us all.
Dog disappears in a poof of smoke, and you can. The tree is pulled over. You have. Now go claim the. Claim the item of our desires. It may be of use to you later on. And then she disappears as well.
I'm gonna cast Detect Magic as I walk forward.
There is a strong magic on in the rubble surrounding the roots of the fallen tree.
Okay, true. I'll sort through it.
Yeah, do a search.
You're almost immediately able to find a copper dagger.
Nice.
A corn handle and a copper blade. It looks ceremonial and looks ancient.
But it's magical.
It's magical, yes.
Huh.
There's some sort of keeping on it.
So are we, like, bros with the fairies now?
I don't think so.
Well, we managed to not kill them for once. And we have a copper dagger, and now we could get paid. So let's sure. Go do that and get out of here before the Fae change their mind.
Everybody wins.
Sounds good to me.
You guys handled that perfectly.
Goodness. I was freaking out. God.
Did planting the trees help?
No, it didn't, but you just about...
Don't tell them that!
But the fact that you asked for an audience, that pretty well, that was the exact perfect thing to do.
So how much XP did we lose by thing. Not just killing them?
Not a whole lot. He would have been a bit of a challenge, but not bad.
Well, you think?
Plus, we planted some trees, guys. We can feel good about that. Especially being a wood elf. That makes me happy.
I'm not, so...
Okay. So you each get your 60 gold pieces each. And he
oh, that was each?
Profusely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Get my book money back.
We tell the Minotian to talk well of us.
Yeah.
Tell our story.
We fought well.
The fact that you got the wood means that you are patched up even sooner because it was some very fine quality wood that you got a hold of, and now you are. In less than a week, you are ready to go. If unless you want to continue bumming around Cliff Watch for a little while.
No, let's take the dagger
to the alchemist and see if
he immediately can identify. And forever.
The alchemist is kind of at a loss. He says, that's quite a piece you have there, but I can't really speak to what that might be.
Do you know of any other arcane vendors in the area that could possibly help me?
Yeah, certainly. He points you towards a magical item shop. Well, not a magical item shop, but a wizard's tower.
Okay.
There in town. It's actually someone known as the Geomancer.
The Geomancer. I will go to the Geomancer.
Is the Geomancer named Toph?
No.
I am
Geomancer is just known as the Geomancer. He is it is a dwarf of indeterminate age. And he stands before you in full-on armor and says, what can I do for you?
I was wondering if you could help me identify the properties of this magical item.
Certainly. What do you offer for that?
Oh, I have gold if you're interested. I'm sure we have
other... It's always an interesting gold.
Oh, of course. How much would that run me? Yeah.
100 gold pieces to identify.
I'll throw in 50.
Yeah? Do we want to identify that stupid bee dart, too?
Didn't we already do that?
Mm-mm.
What about Yolanda's necklace?
Oh, we got so much to identify.
Yeah.
Wait. Can our gnome identify? He might do it for free. We haven't even asked him.
Let's ask him. Yeah.
We'll go back and ask our gnome friend if he can do it.
Trella says, well, of course I can identify these items.
Oh. Well, we have 3.
Okay.
What would you like to identify first? We have that wizard staff, too.
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
Oh, I'd forgotten about that one.
Some sort of magical arrows as well. At least that's what it says in our thing.
Twenty magical arrows. So we have a lot to identify.
Yeah. 5 things.
Okay. I don't know if you have that many spells today.
Hate fancy and casting so much. No idea.
It's going to be one of the next spells I learn if I can learn it. I don't know.
I pour everyone a tankard of ale from the cask of ale in our bag of holding. Even the gnome. Trella.
He says, okay, what would you like identified first?
Let's go with the necklace. Yeah.
He focuses on the necklace for a short period of time and says, "This is a necklace of restriction."
Oh no!
It's drawing her to a prison that was created for wild magic users.
Hey! Zing.
Thus the reason I said, oh my god, she just put that on. That is amazing.
That is straight fantastic.
Oh no.
Holy cow.
So you're being drawn towards a prison is what
Well, yeah, because I need asylum. To rescue the people who are there. Let's go.
That's amazing. Can you get it off?
No, you would have to have you have to go to the source of it to get it removed.
The prison?
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Okay, so that's plan not anytime soon. Next?
Gosh.
I need to save my fellow dude.
We will. We will at some point.
Going southwest.
On a giant to-do list.
All right, break into a magic prison.
The magical arrows?
Magical arrows. Which ones were those?
It says 20 magic arrows. You picked up from
somewhere. They were just plus one arrows.
Oh, joy.
Do you want 10? And then Bayo and I can have, like, 5 each?
I say we just use them like we did the silver arrows.
Yeah, just like...
Just assume that they are distributed however will work out and just take it out of the party loot.
I mean, I don't use arrows as... often as I want to.
Yeah, that's the main reason why.
Yeah. I use them all the time, so.
Okay.
I guess.
Okay. Alright,
what about this fancy dagger?
Yeah.
Fancy dagger?
Old fancy dagger.
He says that he actually is not sure what it is. It's something that's beyond an identify spell.
Oh, what?
It does have... It is the equivalent of a plus one dagger, but that's pretty much all he can get from it. But there's much more to it.
Okay.
And that's pretty much all of the... Well, he has one more spell.
Bead dart.
The B dart is a plus one dart.
Cool. That's just shaped like a B?
Just shaped like a B.
Sure. Why not?
Buzza, 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 buzza.
Were any of us even proficient in darts?
I think I probably am. I'm a fighter. I'm proficient in everything.
Well, now you are.
I think darts are a simple weapon, so...
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Charlie wants it.
Oh no, I have nothing I can use it with. I'm just excited that if the time came, I could use it.
That's true.
But I shouldn't.
I don't want
it. Let's not forget, guys. This is my strength.
Give it to her. Oh my goodness.
Just use it on those prison guards that I am sure all of us are in a rush to help you meet. None of us are in a rush to help. All
right. Anyone opposed to me having the dagger?
People being trapped is just upsetting.
So, like... Seriously, in however many days before the ship gets repaired,
he has
3 identify spells.
No, he can, I'm just saying that for the first day. Yeah. This is, he identifies the rest of the stuff, as well.
I think there was a book and a staff.
There wasn't book. There was armor made out of books.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. The wizard staff is a plus one focus for to hit, basically. So it's a plus one focus staff.
Cool.
And the spellbook armor is just the equivalent of leather armor. There actually isn't anything magic about it.
Interesting.
Other than the fact that it's made out of spell books.
So, can we just go ahead and sell that off?
Yeah, sure.
Who would buy it, and for how much?
Who cares? I'm just going to add half the purchase price.
Sure.
So, that makes 5 gold.
I will shake the man's hand who buys that off of us.
3 gold.
That's awesome. So, can I have a dagger, guys? Is that okay? So I can stab stuff with it?
It's okay.
Okay.
It'll be like my backup weapon in case my longsword of dancing fighters doesn't want to work.
Do any of us actually have a use for magical dart?
That's Charlie. I think she was the most interested.
I don't have anything that, I don't have like a dart blower. I think that's the,
Darts are thrown.
Oh, I'll just take it. Mm-hmm.
Charlie's it is then.
Okay.
Is this giant ale and half barrel of ale the same thing?
No. One's the giant ale from when I had my drinking contest with the giant. The other one is just our ale to drink.
All right. Does Yolanda want the staff?
I already have a wand for a focus, so unless it does anything particularly fantastic, I'm all right.
All right. I really don't want to look up how much a plus one focus would sell for.
$20 gold. 35 gold.
I really hope it's more than 25
gold. It's going to be more than that. I'm trying to... Sorry, I'm looking it up. Well, there's really not a price on it, unfortunately, but... it's common...
Does not seem right to me for some reason.
Let's see, an uncommon plus one weapon is uncommon.
Yeah. I would say that's probably going to be uncommon. So, an uncommoner. Let's just say you could get 300 gold pieces for it.
Okay. All right. Everybody add 82 gold.
82. I can't math. Okay.
I'd trade the plus one arrows for a plus one bow.
Not quite yet.
Why can't I roll?
Wait a second. Magic item rarity, uncommon. 101 to 500 gold. Can I just buy a plus one bow?
Go ask the dwarf.
Well, I'm asking the GM who controls the dwarf. And every other shopkeeper in the entire world.
You know what? Yes, you can buy a plus one bow.
Thank you.
Anybody else that wants to do that. Buy any magical items at this point, we can, because the geomancer is quite powerful.
Cool. How much is
it? Well, let's say it's 500.
And I'll go see what else he has.
I think plus one, two, and three is effectively the only actual magical bows, so...
Yeah, it would be plus one. We could add to it later on, but for right now,
I no. I mean, like all the stuff like frost and flame and stuff aren't allowed on bows in the according to the book.
That's silly, but
yeah. It's like one magical bow that's like really bad.
That works.
Well, I'm sure somebody is working on them as we speak, or has worked on them. Okay, anybody else getting anything?
Yeah, I'm going to see what else he has to sell.
What are you looking for?
I don't even know. I'm in the market.
You're in the market for some magic, eh?
Yeah.
All right.
He says, well, I've got a variety of items. Your friend took my bow that I've had for quite some time on the market. But I have various items that are quite powerful. I have this ring that turns earth elementals once per day.
What?
That's kind of cool.
That's really pretty.
Hey guys, you know what? Bag of Tricks is listed as uncommon.
No, it's not happening.
That bag of tricks has held this group.
It's saved us on many occasions.
It just saved us yesterday.
Plus, I think if we really focus on the gambling aspect of the bag of tricks at taverns like we originally planned, it would pay for itself.
It's fine.
Exactly.
You know, the tan bag of tricks has a black bear.
Ooh.
I thought the brown bear is bigger.
It is.
Ha!
Well, yes, but then we have two types of bears.
Does he have a bag of tricks to sell?
He does not have a
bag of tricks. Get my hopes up.
The only bag of tricks in the universe.
Get my hopes up like that.
For the time being.
All right.
He also has a pair of sending stones that he's willing to sell.
Those are nice. How much are both of those? Well, separately.
The item for turning earth elementals is the ring is 450 gold pieces. The sending stones are 300 gold pieces.
I can go carve these on something.
Someone else wants to. You want to split the sending stones?
I may be a dumb fighter, but what are sending stones, guys?
They're, you know, stones. They send stuff.
How do they work?
I mean,
they
know
do whatever it is.
I don't know if my character knows what they are.
Geomancer. I'm just a dumb fighter, not versed in magic. What are these stones you speak of?
They allow you to send messages between the two stones once per day. You can send a short message.
So we can, you know, keep an eye on Jika.
Oh my gosh, the Jika phone.
No, that is not worth 300 gold pieces.
It totally is.
Welcome
I'm buying them.
To my life.
Just
welcome
the sending stones.
My Tanner, this entire campaign.
Oh.
I bought them. They're mine.
It's so dumb. That cheap. Alright, well, we should probably take the ring because that's pretty fantastic.
Yeah. I'll go in the hearth if you want.
Wait, have we actually fought any Earth Elementals?
No.
He says, ensuring that we will fight 83 of them in a row if we do not buy it.
Well, anything else fancy?
Nothing that really jumps out at you.
Okay. I mean,
unless you really want something, and then we'll talk.
I don't know what I want. A ring of shadows, please, from the Encyclopedia de Magica.
Unfortunately, don't.
Just throwing it out there. All right. I don't know. I'll take the ring.
Okay.
No need to go halvesies. I'll just take it.
Okay.
Seeing as I'll probably just use it to save Bayo's butt.
Please do.
That's my job in the group. I can't get my dagger to roll, though. Everything else is working.
All right, I'm going to need to take a short break, but I'll be back in just a few minutes. Sure. So if you guys want to take a little breather, that's fine.
Yeah. I guess I will.
I'll try to figure this out.
Oh, here we go. This is what we need.
No! Why?
Oh? Is the dagger not working?
Nope.
But
there's something saying no to the broom.
Oh, but it's so cool!
We don't need a magic broom.
We don't need one. That doesn't mean we don't want one. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. Here, this. This is what we need. Yesterday.
What is it? So many things. Ah!
Why is
What's happening?
She just posted the entire magic book ever. She hit select all and hit paste.
Oh no, oh. I know what happened. It's, I didn't hit select all. I just did half of it.
Oh gosh.
That's awesome.
Well, we have a list of magic items to choose from now.
Yeah. Now we don't even need
the
book.
Chat, though. So the first thing was an amulet of health, amulet of proof against detection of location. Which one were you looking at?
The Helm of Comprehend Languages.
Oh, yes. I want three of them. Although I wouldn't be able to reply back, would I? I would just be able to comprehend them. I can't.
Yeah, it basically just gives you comprehend languages at will, so you can understand, but there's a helm of telepathy?
So many helms. I love it. Bag of beans?
We could get a robe of useful items. It might just be full of portable rams and dogs.
What? Oh, now, okay. So I want a bag of tricks, which I have. I'm gonna get a bag of beans next. And then I need another bag for something. I need three bags just to attune myself to. I'll be the bag mage. Be great.
Bag mage.
The bag mage.
Here we go. robe of useful items. It's full of random shit.
That's totally me. I want this bag of beans, though. I've never even heard of it. You roll a 1d100, and anything could happen.
I mean, you get a portable ram, a window. It could just have a window in it.
What is this? A sack? Is that what just...
Hey guys, I see an item that we should probably think about.
What?
The alchemy jug.
Oh yeah. I should have won.
Dude. It could produce 2 gallons of mayo.
Strangely, so I think Jika could as well. And I wouldn't even ask where it came from. I would just know that Jika can produce 2 gallons of mayo.
Per day?
Over a prolonged period or just immediately? Because that's going to be the worrying part.
It says it pours out up to 2 gallons per minute. And... once it starts producing, it can't produce a different one or more of one that has reached its maximum until the next dawn. Alright, give me one sec.
I don't understand. This is not working. Dex.
There we go, my headphones are kind of twisted.
Range, magic bonus. Okay.
And it's listed as uncommon.
Is not working.
Is what now?
My copper dagger won't roll. Hold on, let me refresh the page. Let's see. Copper dagger. Oh, what is it? What? Hey!
Fancy, I like it.
Okay, so I think I know what happened. Should be a plus 8. Here we go. The damage is 1d4 plus my dex, plus 1, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. That's working.
Here we go. Pipes of the sewers.
The what?
Pipes of the sewers. You have to be proficient with wind instruments. While you are attuned to the pipes, rats and giant rats are indifferent towards you and will not attack. You can call forth a swarm of rats.
Okay.
Jesus, why would you want it?
Why would you not?
Okay, I'm back. I've got a little something to eat, so if you hear chomping, that's just what it is. Not being eaten by giant rats.
Considering all of the horrible things that try to kill us in sewers, having them kill, you know, rats instead, yeah, might not be that bad.
I would like to buy the Holy Avenger, please.
Good luck with that.
Oh, I'm not a paladin. I will multi-class with a paladin, please.
So, alchemy jar, guys?
No. You can buy it. I'm not.
It can also make 4 gallons of beer.
Bayou is broke.
I'm okay with stuff.
Yeah, I got a fancy ring.
All right, so what are you guys doing these days? Just waiting for the ship to be repaired?
I'll try and earn some money with just, like, music performance stuff.
Ooh, and we're going to find a bar to have our bet place thing.
Okay.
Bayonet.
You guys arrange a place where you can actually do your animal fights. It's a dwarven bar called the Broken Matic. Alanda, they're interested in you entertaining there as well, so.
Cool. Make money, money, make money, money, money.
Your first set goes very, very well, and you're able to make a few silver pieces.
Nice.
Generally, it's a pretty happening place. A lot of dwarves.
Oh, yeah. All right, Bale. You can help me set this up?
We believe in you.
All right, maybe it's just me.
Bam. You live?
Like did you hear me?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Oh, no, sorry. Okay. I was muted.
All right.
You
gonna help me set this up?
Go. Yeah, sure.
Okay. So I guess we're just gonna go around. Talking to people and taking bets.
Yep. Okay. So first I yell out about the main event. It's a betting contest between two ferocious animals that will appear in the middle of the bar and fight to the death.
Ferocious.
So you can either bet on the first animal or the second animal.
Okay.
Technically the third to defeat the winner of the first round for double the odds.
Now they have to fight me.
What, the animal, or?
Yeah, we'll see where this goes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll see what happens. Do we have a pretty good pot for the winnings, I guess?
So what are you planning? How are you planning on distributing the money? Are you taking like a percentage off the top or what?
Yeah, I think if we take 5%,
something like that.
Okay.
And then, what should we charge for everyone for the bets?
Nah, take 5%.
No, but what should we? Okay. Yeah, we'll just take 5% off the top.
Yeah, just whatever.
Okay, there's about 20 gold pieces worth of bets that have been made. So.
Okay.
Okay.
In this corner. Hey, a lion. All right. That's a good start.
Nice. Versus the ferocious
lion.
Terrible lion.
Okay, I'm going to let you guys fight that out as best you can. All right,
Bayo, just roll a d20.
D20.
You're the first one. I'm the second one.
Okay, I'll be number one.
Yeah, you win.
Ah, we gotta do a best out of three.
Best out of three?
Yep.
Two. Oh.
Oh, no, tied.
Three. Ah, you definitely.
Oh. First lion wins. Rips the throat of the other lion. Blood splatters all over the guys in the front row.
And it turns into a flop ball.
Okay.
And now we Ready take bets on Bayo versus the remaining one.
Or do we want to do Bayo versus the third one?
Bayo versus two lions at once.
Should we throw out the last one and see what it is and then make bets?
Do both. Take bets before and after.
There we go.
Yeah, we'll see if anyone will pitch in before.
See who'll be the all-time champion of the Animal Furball Fighting League. So number three is...
All right.
So Bayo the rat is almost immediately snapped up by the lion.
Oh, yeah. All right, Bayo versus a wounded lion. Any takers? Any bets? Anyone?
There are people betting on the fight?
No one's that interested because they're pretty sure that you'll be able to win handedly.
Can
the
I
odds are definitely not in your favor. Or
Can
definitely in your favor.
Singing a song about how this lion is actually like a lion from myth, and it's only it pretends to be wounded to entice in its prey, and oh no, it's a big old story or something.
We could do Bayo versus an earth elemental.
You realize that we're all horrible people, right?
Yeah. Yes.
I really want to try this thing out anyway.
Is there like people fighting at this establishment?
There is now, apparently.
People are kind of looking at you a little weird that you're going to be fighting a lion, but you know, they're up for it.
Okay. Are there any bets being placed?
They're mostly for you, Bayo.
Okay.
I'm gonna sing a song about Stay Stay the Lion, because that's his name, and about how he was injured as a baby. His foot was in a trap, but he grew up around it, and he just looks like he's limping. He's actually at full health, and he's amazing. God. That's gonna be my song.
Let's see how
this
goes.
I have a better idea. How many hit points do you think the lion lost?
At half.
Which is how much?
Energy.
26.
Is it 26?
Yeah.
It now has 21 of those back.
Okay.
Oh, gosh. All right, so it's full health lion.
Should I fight it barehanded?
If we aren't getting enough bets against you, we might do that.
Okay, I set my weapons aside with my group, peeling off my axe and my sword and my bow and all my armor and everything. Well, I'll leave my armor on, but...
I hand you a chair.
Well, duh, naturally, I'm going to be grabbing chairs.
Okay.
The chair is coming out of your cut, Bayo.
Did the bets increase?
The bets have increased.
Yes.
All right. I'll roll for the lion.
Are we actually going to do the fight?
Sure.
For damage?
Yeah.
I think you have double its hit points. Just warning.
I do.
Okay. The challenge rating is 1.
And I'm fighting it barehanded, though. That's only a 1d4.
That's true. All right, see what happens.
Do I get a strength bonus on that? 1d4 plus my strength? How does that work?
You're fighting with chairs.
You're fighting with chairs, but you're proficient with chairs, right?
I'm proficient, yeah. So is my proficiency bonus? So
like proficiency bonus is there, and your strength bonus. So.
Oh, okay.
It's just like normal, but it's 1d4.
Gotcha.
Feels like a dagger, which is...
Okay. Roll for initiative, Abeo.
Oh, initiative? Sorry. There we go.
Okay. You go first.
All right. Let's see if I hit the guy. Oof. No. Miss.
Okay.
This might have been a bad idea.
The lion sort of... the lion rears up and attacks you with its claws.
Okay. Hit. Oh. With a critical.
Oh, man. Didn't make it any money.
So 2d6 plus 3.
Guys, I think we've found a new fighter for our group.
12 points of damage.
12 points?
Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
Okay.
All right, your turn.
That hits.
Yep.
And I punch it in the head, I have two.
That misses.
What?
11.
Well, 11 plus his strength, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah, that hits.
Okay. Yeah, it could be a 17.
Okay.
So then I get two attacks because I have my extra attack now. So I'm going to punch it in the face, give it a good right, and then a left.
Okay.
Right and a left. Very nice.
Okay. Nice job. Okay, it attacks you back.
Hit. You guys aren't cheering me on at all, are you? Come on. Getting a lion for money.
Go, lion, go!
9 points of damage.
Go, lion, go. I'm indecisive.
Go, lion, go.
Okay.
Okay, now it's up to you, Bale.
12.
Okay. Does that hit? Yeah, that hits.
And I'm gonna just go at it again. Two attacks. Total of 20.
Yeah, it falls down dead. They're being hit by the chair. Or fists.
My fist? I didn't even pick up a chair.
Okay.
That's amazing.
The crowd cheers, and money is, of course, exchanged. You guys take your cut of what's left. There's about 40... there's about 40 gold that was exchanged, so whatever the 5% on that is.
That's 2 gold.
Yeah.
So 50 copper apiece.
I give 1 gold to Bale. This is,
what,
you guys
weren't, 2 gold?
You guys weren't with our bets. This is me and Bale. I didn't give
this is what's going to break up the party.
Yeah, right.
I healed the lion so that people would actually bet on the fight. And Yolanda was doing propaganda and advertising the whole
time. I look at everybody and just go, "Are you not entertained?"
Comes the mostly Gorman crowd.
I'd say it's Earth Elemental versus all the dwarves. What do you say?
Where are you going to get an Earth Elemental?
From the ring.
The ring turns earth elementals.
Then, yeah.
Like clerics do to undead?
Yep. Yep.
Oh.
That's why I was skeptical of the usefulness.
We can always buy something that conjures earth elementals and then piss them off, and then you can turn them so that they're our friends again.
I thought turning them just makes them, like, run away.
Hmm.
And who was the idiot for buying the item they did? Not this guy.
Hey, I wanted to buy another bag of tricks and an alchemy jar.
For mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise.
Well, not just mayonnaise, also beer and acid. I mean, dude, it could give like 8 ounces of acid per day. We could totally make the money back in, like, a month.
Eh, I'm okay. I have a half-decent ring that I'll use probably once in my life.
And don't worry, Nathan, that's about as close as I'm ever going to get to remotely competent min-maxing.
Fifth edition.
Is that what this is? Or is it Ring of Elemental Command, or is it Ring of Turning?
It's just an elemental turning.
Okay.
It's I just came up with it on the spot, so.
Okay.
Cool.
Okay.
I think we should go back to the ship.
Yeah. I think we're done.
Made 2 gold off of our fighting racket.
50 copper apiece.
Okay. You're not going to get rich that way, but, you know.
We just got to find a better betting crowd is the problem.
Mm-hmm. We'll figure out how to make more money.
Yeah, I don't know, the dwarves aren't into drunkenness and gambling.
But people on a ship always are.
Damn right.
There's bare knuckle boxing amongst sailors, aren't there?
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
I think Yolanda should do some bare knuckle boxing.
Yes!
That can be arranged.
Puns. Always with the puns. Okay. So you guys make your way back to the ship. It's largely repaired at this point. The wood that they had has pretty well patched the missing bands that you have. They've pitched it. It looks like it's going to hold, and it's looking good. You're probably going to be able to take off the next day.
Nice.
Oh, good. When I'll be able to cure another lion again. Or, you know, a party member who is definitely more valuable than a ball of fluff that we would get back anyways.
Yeah.
The emotional attachment to the lion.
Yes, I have. Yes, considering I just pummeled it into a ball of fur again. Yes, we have a real emotional attachment to this dumb lion.
He won't remember you tomorrow.
But we don't know that.
No, I tested it. Remember, like a billion times.
Tested. No, that was tricks.
Tricks.
I don't remember anything.
I murdered it. There's going to come a point where that lion, when you throw one, is going to attack me.
Well, that was... No, that was the first lion. Never mind.
Well, that's going to be something we all live with.
Yep. Thanks, guys.
You can kill the lion anyway. You just did it with your bare hands.
If only it was a bear.
Okay, I hope you guys don't mind, but I think I might call it for tonight.
That's all right.
Kind of run out of content. A couple of things I thought were going to go longer than they actually did.
Like the wolf?
I thought we had a battle involved with that hound, but that creature.
Calling it now that we're out of animals to abuse.
And you're out of animals to abuse for the day, and yeah, so.
Sounds good.
Okay, well, sorry that I cut it short, and we started late, but 8 o'clock next Thursday, and everybody going to be able to make it?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
Okay, great. I might see about finding us a fifth person, but I know I've been saying that for a while, but I might actually do it this week. I'll do an interview with them. That's sort of the plan, is do a Skype interview, figure out if somebody's going to be a fit or not, because, cool. You know, we've obviously, we have a good group here, and we don't want to screw it up by introducing somebody that's horrible.
First question in the interview. Is your character going to be in elf? If not, please leave.
How do you feel about murdering innocent balls of fur for profit?
That bag of tricks was my greatest regret.
It's my greatest thing ever.
And yet I think it is the best thing that has happened to this campaign. I mean, the sheer amusement that we have gotten out of that.
It's so good. An owl killed a giant.
An owl did kill a giant.
That never happened.
That is true.
That has happened zero times.
It never ever happens in real life.
Never happens in fake life.
No. All right, well, I'm going to get some sleep, and you guys have a great evening, and I will see you next week.
All right.
Sounds good.
All right, see you guys. Talk to you later. Starts logging off. Do any of you have Overwatch?
Nope.